My heart for this generation, my heart for this time in our history is that we will become the hands and feet of Jesus. And I think the perfect example of that is the woman at the well. She was a woman with a past. She was not viewed by her culture as valuable. In fact, she was viewed as so unworthy that she was allowed to do something dangerous and nobody cared. She walked to the well by herself, and we don't appreciate in our modern time how unusual that would have been. The women of her community didn't value her, and the men in her life did not value her as a person. So she was allowed to go out to this well by herself. She then encounters Jesus. Jesus does something extraordinary. He looks at this woman and he sees past her race and he sees past her gender and he speaks to her. Something that would not have happened in that day. She's a Samaritan and she's a woman. I'm not going to talk to her. But he looked past it all and he saw someone of value and he saw someone of worth. And he told her everything she had ever done. And in the process, she goes back to her people. In fact, he tells her, now go tell your people that you met the Messiah. So he takes this really messed up, broken person, hello, and he says, now go and be the first evangelist. Go and tell your people that you met the Messiah, that he's here, the one you've been waiting for, the one that's going to bring you life and new hope. Go and tell your people. That is such an incredible message for us. So many of us sit in silence and shame, thinking we're unworthy. Or we look at other people and we think they can be thrown away because they're unworthy. But that is simply not the way Jesus does things. He looks with love and compassion in the eyes of every person, and he brings life and hope. And that is my passion, and that is my heart, to see the eyes of every broken person in my path and share the love and hope and life that they can experience in Jesus Christ.